Everyone. So let us continue with solving problems on continuous beams by Kani's method. So last classes we have solved the two problems on continuous beam where the end supports were fixed. So today we are solving this continuous beam where the last support A is hinged support. So as you are aware, if the last support is simple roller or hinged, then moment at that particular support it will be zero, correct? So how to take care of this by Kani's method? Let us solve this particular problem. So as we discussed, there are total four steps. First step is finding the fixed moment. Second step will be finding rotation factor. Third step, iterative table, that is Kani's boxes. And finally, we'll be finding what will be the support moments. Okay, so step one. To find fixed end moments. So here there are two spans, AB and C. On AB span, there is a moment, that is external moment, acting anti-clockwise at a distance 2 meters and meters. On BC span, there are two types of loading. One is UDL and one more is concentrated load of 30 kilonewton. At a distance 4 meters and 2 meters. Okay, so I hope you are aware about the formula to calculate fixed moment for moment acting at a distance A and B. Let me write that. You will be finding MF AB. So this is minus MB into 2A minus B divided by L square. Okay, so what this minus sign indicates? So when the moment is acting anti-clockwise, the fixed end moments developed at both the ends, they will be anti-clockwise only. Okay, so if I draw that, so suppose this is anti-clockwise moment, the deflection of this, it will be something like this. It will come and hit here. Similarly, it will come and hit here. So to resist this, the fixed end moments developed will be, this is also anti-clockwise. So this is also anti-clockwise. This is MFAB and this is MFBA. So remember, whenever you come across a external moment where it will be anti-clockwise, both the ends, fixed moments developed will be anti-clockwise. If it is clockwise, both the ends, fixed moments developed will be clockwise only. Okay. So here, MFAB, since it is anti-clockwise moment, minus MB into 2A minus B by L square. So if you substitute the values, M is 50 kilonewton, B is this 4 meters and 2 into A, this is 2 meters minus again B is 4 meters. This is A, this is B divided by L square. Total it is 6 square. So this is minus. So if you simplify this, you will be getting 0. Yeah. So it is plus zero or minus zero, need not require the unit. So ultimately, you'll be getting this as zero. You do the calculation. So you'll be getting MFB as zero. So need not write minus zero plus zero. Even unit is not required. Let it be. So second one, MFBA. To calculate MFBA, the formula is minus M into A, 2B minus A divided by L square. So this is the formula to calculate MFB2A. So again, substitute the values. If you substitute, M is 50 into A is 2 meters into 2 into B. It is 4 meters minus A is 2 divided by L is 6 square. So if you simplify this, you will be getting minus 16.67 minus 16.67 kilonewton meter. This is MFBA. Okay, MFAB and MFBA for external movement acting anti-clockwise. These are the formulas. Okay, similarly here, if you consider a BC span, okay, you will be finding MFBC and MFCB. Okay, on BC span there are two loads, so ultimately the friction moments due to two different types of load will be applied by your principle of superposition, then calculate addition of those two effects. Correct. So due to UDL, it is, what is that? Due to UDL, WL square by 12 plus, due to this concentrated load at a distance 4 meters and 2 meters, WA square by L square. So total it is anti-clockwise movement. So fixed end movements developed will be like this always to make the beam hog. The loadings will be making the beam sag. Correct. So MFBC is negative. So MFCB will be positive. So now again, due to UDL, it is WL square by 12 plus, due to concentrated load, WA square B by L square. Okay. So now if you substitute these values, ultimately if you calculate, MFBC you will be getting minus 43.33. This is minus 43.33 kilonewton meter. So this is CB 56.67 kilonewton meter. Okay, so these are the fixed end moments: MFAB, MFBA, MFBC, MFCB. Okay, so there are two different types of loadings. So ultimately, like superposition, principle of superposition, if you apply it, so you'll be getting what is MFBC and MFCB. Okay, step one is over. Once you find the fixed end moment, step two. Yeah, step two. It is to find rotation factor U. So rotation factor is found at the intermediate support. Correct. So here the intermediate support is only one, that is B. That is the support where two spans are connected. So B to A and B to C. So we'll be finding this rotation factor at intermediate joints. So here it is, joint B. So you need to make this double column, joint member, then relative stiffness, summation of relative stiffness, then rotation factor minus 0.5 times distribution factor, that is K divided by summation of K. Correct. As usual, like how we have done the previous two problems, similarly you are doing this. Okay. So joint B, that is the intermediate joint, respect to B, the members associated are B to A, B to C, BA and BC. Then relative stiffness with respect to B, the support A, that is hinged. Okay, with respect to a joint, if the neck support, if it is simple, roller or hinged, then relative stiffness will be 3/4 of I by L. Only if it is fixed or continuous, then it is I by L. So now with respect to B, A, it is hinged. If it is hinged, it is 3/4 of I by L. So EI is constant here. They have not given any moment of inertia changing for spans. So it is only 3/4 of I by L. 3/4 I divided by L for BA span, it is total 6 meters. So similarly with respect to B, C is fixed. If it is fixed, it is I by L. So it is I by L is again, it is 6 meters. Okay. So if you do this calculation in terms of decimals, then if you calculate sigma k, so it will be 0.292i. So 0.292i. Okay. So then k divided by summation of k into minus 0.5. So if you do that, so for BA you will be getting minus 0.21. For BC you will be getting minus 0.29. Okay. So as we know, at the joint, ultimately summation of rotation factor should be minus 0.5. Yes, you are getting minus 0.5. Okay, that is the cross check what you can do. So this is a rotation factor for BA, rotation factor for BC, minus 0.21, minus 0.29. Here only one joint, intermediate joint. Okay, this is step 2. So once step 2 is over, then step 3, that is to find rotation moments by iterative table, correct? That is by Carney's boxes. That is nothing but Carney's boxes. Correct. So you'll be drawing the Carney's box. So this is hinged A to B. This is intermediate joint. This is B. This is A. Then this is C. Correct. So rotation moments will be calculating at the intermediate joint. So that is M dash BA, M dash BC. Okay. So this iterative procedure will be taking place only if there are two intermediate joints are there, then 3 to 4 trials are required minimum. If only one intermediate joint is there, only one trial is sufficient. Okay. So let us write the values first. So above this top of the horizontal line, writing the friction moments, MFAB you got 0, MFBA it is minus 16.67, then MFBC it is minus 43.33, MFCB it is 56.67. Okay, so summation of friction moment at a joint, if you add these two, you will be writing it here. So you will be getting minus 60, and you have found already the rotation factors. For BA member it is 0.21, this is 0.21. For BC member it is 0.29. Okay, so now it is important to know the past supports. This is hinged. This is fixed. It is important to know the last supports. So as we are aware, if the last supports are simple roller or hinged, then moment about that particular support will be zero. Okay, support moment, final moment, whatever you are going to calculate, it is zero. If some value is there here, that is MFAB, then first you need to make that zero and need to transfer the half of the moment to the next support after making it zero. Okay, how we have done in case of moment distribution method, the same procedure you need to apply here also. But in this case, MFAB is already zero, so we need not to worry about that. Okay, so if it is hinged roller or simple support, the last support, then first you need to release this particular moment. You need to make it zero by adding or by subtracting. So how much is that? Okay, so how much you are adding or how much you are subtracting, in that 50% of the moment is transferred to the next support and it will be added here. But here we need not to worry, because so already MFAB is zero here. Okay, so need not to release again, make this particular moment at A as zero because it is already zero. We need not to worry. So we can directly continue with finding rotation moments. Okay, so you will be finding rotation moments M dash AB is equal to. So what is the formula? Rotation factor, summation of fixed end moment at a joint plus far end rotation moments. Correct? Rotation factor, summation of fixed end moment at a joint plus summation of rotation moments from far ends. Correct? So you're finding only M dash AB and M dash BA. Okay, one trial, because only one intermediate joint, only one trial is sufficient, such that you will not be getting the rotation moment from the other joints. Okay, only one trial is sufficient. So summation of fixed moment at a joint, it is rotation factor, sorry, minus 0.21 for AB, A to B, it is minus 0.21. Summation of fixed moment at a joint, it is minus 60 plus initial value rotation moment from both the far ends, from B, far end A, far end C. From here zero, this is first trial, will be getting some value. So similarly, B to C. So AB, and sorry, this is BC, M dash BC. Okay, so minus 0.29, fixed end moment at a joint is minus 60, plus again 0, 0. If you simplify this, you will be getting, this is 12.60, this is 17.4. So rotation moments M dash BA, sorry, M dash B to A, from here to here, M dash B to C. So with respect to intermediate joint, B to A, B to C. So M dash BA, you are getting 12.60. M dash BC, you are getting 17.40. Okay. So these are rotation moments. Once you get this, then finally you will be finding final moments. That is last step. Step number 4. Final moments. MAB equal to, directly I will write it as 0. Okay. So to calculate this final moments, you are having a formula. Okay. What is that formula? Fixed end moment plus 2 times near end rotation moments plus forint rotation moment. Okay, so this formula I will not apply for MAB because already I know it. If the last support is simple roller or hinge, moment is zero. So again, I will not apply this formula. However, here friction moment was zero, so that is a different thing. So do not apply the equation. Do not apply the equation for calculation of MAB because the last support is that is hinged. So directly we will write zero. Then MBA. So B2A MBA. Fixed end moments MFBA. So MFBA equals minus 16.67 plus 2 times near end rotation moments. That is M dash B2A is the near end rotation moment. So it is 12.0 plus far end rotation moment. B2A, A is the far end. From far end it is 0. Similarly, MBC, fixed end moment, BC, MBC, it was minus 43.33 plus 2 times B2C you are writing. Near end is B, far end is C. At near end, there is a rotation moment, that is M dash BC, 17.40. Far end, this C, there was no rotation moment. So it is 0. So next, last, MCB from C to B, fixed end moment, MCB it is 56.67 plus 2 times near end rotation moment, here it was 0, plus from far end M dash BC, that is 17.40. Okay, so now if you solve this, you will be getting this is 8.53. So this is minus 8.53 and this is 74.07. 74.07. These are the final moments. Okay, so these are the final moments. MAB 0, MBA, MBC should be same with opposite sign. 8.53 minus 8.53. Then MCB is 74.07. Okay, so once you find this final support moments, then you will be drawing the actual bending moment diagram and shear force diagram. I hope you will be doing that because already the last previous two problems I have explained how to draw the actual bending moment diagram and calculation of reaction and also shear force diagram. Okay, you can do that. Okay, so here just for your information, so free bending moment diagram will be drawn for considering simply supported beam. For this, it be like this. Anti-clockwise, if you come and hit here, means here and here. Okay, so this is the free bending diagram for this. M into A by L, M into B by L. This is M A by L. So this height is M B by L. Okay, so free bending diagram for only this, if you consider simply supported beam. The support moment diagram you will draw with a line like previous problem how I have explained. Okay, similarly this, there are two concentrated loads. Okay, so we are not aware about the free bending moment diagram for two different types of loadings. Okay, if that is the case, so how you two need to draw is, consider this span separately This is UDL. This is concentrated load. Okay. A and B. Let us say, so here it is B and C. Calculate RB and RC first. Calculate the reactions. Okay. So free bending diagram, it is due to the load acting on the span. So calculate RB and RC. If you take moment about C equal to 0, so let us say if you take moment about C equal to 0, that is RB into 6 meters minus 30 into 2, this minus 10 into 6 into 6 by 2 equal to 0. So if you solve this, you might be getting some value, okay, RB. So similarly, then if you apply sigma of V equal to 0, RB plus RC minus 30 minus 10 into X equal to 0. So RB is known, so you'll be getting RC. Okay, once we get this values, then take moment about this point. Okay, by considering these reactions, then take moment about this point. Due to the loadings. Here to here it is UDL, maybe it is parabolic. From here to here it is UDL, be parabolic. So this value, so reaction int already have calculated, depending upon that perpendicular distance from UDL, you will calculate what is the height. Okay, so this is the way in which you need to draw the free bending moment diagram if there are two different types of loadings where there is no standard bending moment diagram for that. Okay, so consider the span separately, calculate the reactions, then take moment about this point where the concentric load is acting. This is from here to here it is parabolic, from here to here it is parabolic. Okay, total entire thing is not one, up to here and from here to here, because again here exactly at this point there is a concentrated load. So what is this height? So RB into 4 minus 10 into 4 into 4 by 2. So we'll be getting that. Okay. So this is for your information. This problem. So where I have considered the last support, here it is fixed and here it is simple support. But there is a overhang portion. Let us call this overhang portion as AA dash. Okay. So if this is the case, if overhang portion is given, then how to solve this particular problem by Carney's method. Okay. So as usual, step number one, you will be finding the fixed end moments. Okay. So only for support to support, that span, you will be finding the fixed end moment. Overhang portion, let me discuss. So this is MFAB, MFBA, MFBC, MFCB, MBUDL minus WL square by 12. So this is plus WL square by 12. There are two concentrated load. So this is minus 50. Direct I will write it, or else the formula WA B square B by L square plus for this again WA B square A square B by L square. So this is plus WA square B by L square WA square B by L square. One for 50 kiloNewton, one for 80 kiloNewton. So I hope you remember the previous problem what we solved, the similar type. Okay. So due to this 50, due to this 80, the formulas, then if you substitute the values, you will be getting MFAB as minus 60, MFB as plus 60, MFBC minus 86.25. And MFCB it is 108.75. Okay, so this is as usual procedure where we will be finding spans the fixed end moments. We will restrain AB span you will restrain BC span and what will be the friction moments. With the formula, you can calculate this. Okay. So, in case of moment distribution method, how we have taken care the overhang portion, the similar fashion we need to take care the overhang portion. That moment will be directly known to us. So, whenever you come across the overhang portion, you need to convert that overhang portion into a moment acting at the last support. That will be the final moment. Okay. So, but that moment, when you convert into a last support, that should be resisting moment. So, what is that? Resisting moment. So, how exactly it is rotating? Opposite to that, you need to consider. So, in case of moment distribution method or in case of this Kani's method, you will be converting the overhang portion into a resisting moment. Important. Okay. But in case of matrix method of structural analysis, whether it is a stiffness matrix method or one more flexibility matrix method, you will be converting that overhang portion into a moment acting at the last support in the same direction, not resisting moment. Okay. You need to remember this. Okay. So now if I convert this overhang portion at the last support, this is A, this is UDL, and here it is concentrated load 40 kilonewton, and this is 20 kilonewton per meter, and this is 1 meter. Okay, so this moment is making, actually it is rotating anti-clockwise, but I need to calculate this opposite to that, that is resisting moment. Actually, these loads are making about A, the moment anti-clockwise, but I will be considering opposite to that, clockwise, that is resisting moment. Okay. So if I calculate that, this I say if I H MAA dash is equal to 40 into 1 plus 20 into 1 into 1 by 2. So since it is clockwise, I'll be considering it as plus 40 into 1 plus 20 into 1 into 1 by 2. So if you simplify this, it is 50 kilonewton meter. This is final moment. Okay. So MAA dash, you will be getting 50 kilonewton meter. The overhang portion you have converted into a resisting moment. This is only final plus 50 kilonewton meter. These are fixed end moments. Okay. So step two, as usual, you will be finding the rotation factor at the intermediate joint to find rotation factor Q. Correct. So again, the tabular column joint, let me rub this. Member, relative stiffness, summation of relative stiffness and rotation factor minus 0.5 times distribution factor, that is K divided by summation of K. So now, actually speaking, this is also one of the intermediate joint what we can consider, where it is associated with two spines. But whenever you come across the overhang portion, so consider this as the last support instead of considering the intermediate joint. Okay, do not calculate the rotation factor for this. Okay, for overhang portion, it will be one, rotation factor will be one directly. Okay, so you need not to calculate the relative stiffness also one, you need not to calculate. So only consider this intermediate support as B. Okay, I will be considering only B. This overhang portion support I will not consider. With respect to B, BA and BC. So now with respect to B, A support, it is again, I'll be considering it as simple support. Okay, last support, simple support. It is not a continuous, it is not a fixed. If it is simple support, it is 3/4 of I by L. I by L is 6 meters. Okay, similarly with respect to B, C is fixed, it is I by L, but I is given 2i, so it is 2i by L is total 8 meters. 4, 2, 6, 8. Okay, 8 meters. Okay, now if you simplify this, for BA you will be getting, so total is summation of sigma k is 0.375i. So then minus 0.167 for BA, minus 0.333 for BC, the rotation factors. For BA it will be minus 0.167, for BC it will be minus 0.333. So once again I repeat, do not calculate the rotation factor at this. Okay, so this is connected with overhang portion, so do not calculate. Only from span to span, if it is intermediate support, then only you consider that as an intermediate joint and calculate what is rotation factor. Okay, so once you get this, the next step, it is iterative table. Third step, that is with Carney's boxes. Okay, so now again I will consider the Carney's box only at the intermediate joint, that is at B, not for A support, though it is connected with two spans. Okay, only at B you consider the intermediate support and Carney's box. Okay, this is A, this is B, and this is C. Here it is A dash. Similar to how the beam looks, in the similar fashion, I have drawn only Carney's box at the joint B. Since it is overhang portion, I have not drawn the Carney's box here. Then, so already I have calculated, this is plus 50, rather resisting moment. MFAB it is minus 60, MFBA it is plus 60, MFBC it is 86.25 minus 86.25, MFCB it is 108.75. Then rotation factor minus 0.167 for BA, for BC it is 0.333. Correct. So now, before calculating summation of fixed moment at a joint, then we need to check for the last support. Okay, we need to do some operations here. Okay, so always remember, at a particular joint, the moments at this side and this side, final moments, they will be same with opposite signs. Okay, as we have seen in the previous problems, if you calculate the final moment at B, that is MBA and MBC, they will be having the same magnitude with opposite sign. Similarly here, the MAA dash and MAB should be same with opposite sign. So already you got this as 50, then here you should get minus 50. Here if you got plus 50, this side you should get minus 50. You need to make that arrangement here. Instead of directly calculating this fixed moment, we need to transfer some of the moments. Okay, so now this 50 is final moment, so we need not to make any arrangements. So only this we need to think of, because if it is MA dash 50, MAB should be minus 50. Okay, at a particular joint, the moments acting left side and right side with same magnitude up in the opposite direction. So if I want to make this minus 60, so first what I will do, I will make this as 0. Okay, so earlier it is minus 60. So now I have added plus 60 such that it is 0. So actually what I want minus 50. Now I will add this. Okay, so first I have made 0, then I have added minus 50. Now total here, MAB, that is MFAB, minus 60 here, plus 60 here, and minus 50. So ultimately this is 0, this is minus 50. So once you do that, so now it is final moment. Okay, it is not a fixed moment. Directly it is a final moment. It is not a fixed moment now, because already it is known fact. So MA dash, it is plus 50. MAB, you should get minus 50. So that arrangement you need to make it. First make that as 0, then add minus 50. So how much you have added here, the half of that particular has to go to the next support. Here first I have added plus 60. In that half, it should go to the next support, that is B, plus 30. Similarly, I have added minus 50. So in that half of the moment, that is minus 25. Okay, now if you add it here, the moment it is 60, 90, 65. Okay. Now here, MFBA you will be getting, that is 65. Since you have made some arrangements here, so how much you added? So 50% you need to distribute to the next support. Okay. So then the final fixed moment here, it will be addition of all these things. Plus 60, plus 30, 90, 90 minus 25. So it is 65. Okay. So the, now you can add this and this. If you add here, plus 65 minus 86.25. So you will be getting minus 21.25. Minus 21.25. That is the summation of fixed moments at this joint. From here and from here. Be careful with this. Plus 65 minus 86.25. Ultimately it is minus 21.25. Okay. Now again, you will be finding the rotation moments at the intermediate joint. So here we have considered only here, only one intermediate joint. This is not the intermediate joint what we are considering, since it is associated with the overhang portion. Now the rotation moment formula, what is that? Rotation moment formula. So ultimately it is rotation factor into summation of fixed moment at a joint plus summation of far end rotation moments. Correct. So now I will be calculating M dash BA from B to A and M dash BC from B to C. Only one intermediate joint and only one trial is sufficient. So rotation moment formula, rotation factor for B to A, it is minus 0.167. Fixed end moment at a joint. So if you want, you can write a fixed end moment. So that is minus 21.25 plus from far end rotation moments. So with respect to B, the far ends are C and A. From A and C, this is only one trial. The beginning trial, you will be assuming 0. Okay. So you will be getting 0 here. Again, B to C rotation moment, minus 0.333. Then fixed moment at a joint, minus 21.25. Plus again, far end rotation moments, 0. These are the rotation moments. For M dash BA, you will be getting 3.55. So for BC, you will be getting 7.08 kilonewton meter. Okay, if you want, you can write it here. This is 3.55. So here it is 7.08. So only one trial is sufficient, since only one intermediate joint. Okay. So once you calculate this, then directly step number 4. Final moments. Okay. It is given by fixed end moment plus 2 times near end rotation moment plus far end rotation moments. So MAA dash, the final moment, this already 50 kilonewton meter. Then MAB, it is minus 50 kilonewton meter. Do not apply the equation, this equation for these two. These are final moments. These are final moments. Equation is not applicable for this. Okay, equation is not applicable for this. Directly you write. So MA dash, it is 50 kilonewton meter. MAB, it is minus 50 kilonewton meter. These are the final moments. Okay, only you need to find MBA and MBC and MCB. Okay, so if I calculate that with this formula, MBA, B2A. Okay, this is near end, this is far end. From fixed end moment, it is 65 plus 2 times near end, here it is 3.55 rotation moment. From far end, it is 0. So similarly, MBC, fixed end moment, 86.25 plus 2 times near end is this 7.08, far end it is 0. Similarly, MCB, fixed end moment, 108.75 plus 2 times near end. So this is the near end for this, 0, plus far end it is 7.08. Okay, now if you simplify this, MBA, you will be getting 72.1 kilonewton meter. MBC, it is minus 72.1 kilonewton meter. And MCB, it is 115.83 kilonewton meter. 115.83 kilonewton meter. These are the final answers. Once again, MAA dash, it is plus 50. MAB, it is minus 50. So at a joint, they are same magnitude and opposite directions or opposite signs. So at joint B, you'll be getting MBA and MBC, 72.1, 72.1. One is plus and one more is minus. And MCB, it is 115.83. So please take care this in case of overhang portion. Whenever you come across overhang portion, this is the procedure what you need to do it. Okay, so if this is clear, then this remaining things are only calculation part. So how we have solved the previous problem in similar fashion, you can solve them. Okay, so if you want one note, you can write it here. What is that note? The support with overhang portion, the support with overhang portion rotation factors and Carney's box both are not required. Important. So the support with overhang portion, rotation factor and Carney's box both are not required. So we have not considered the Carney's box here, and also we have not calculated at this particular support the rotation factor. The rotation factor and Carney's box both are not required for support with overhang portion. This is important. Okay, so next you will draw the bending moment diagram, shear force diagram, then again elastic curve. Previous problem, you can refer it and you can draw it. Okay, So in next class, we'll solve few more problems on continuous beam. Wherein I'll be considering with sinking of support, how to take care of that, and also one more problem on overhang portion.